Christmas seems to start so early these days, doesn't it? This year, Harrods actually opened their Christmas department in August. By the time November comes, the adverts are well into the newspapers and television. And of course, we know Christmas is really here when we start to see Christmas decorations appearing. And of course, the prince among all of these is the Christmas tree. There are few people in our country today that don't understand that at the heart of Christmas, Christ Mass, is the celebration of the birth of Jesus Christ. In the modern world, the story of Christmas, as given to us in the Bible, can become hidden by other things that have little or no connection with it. So there are some great images we associate with Christmas, but these may have more of a connection with fiction, fantasy, paganism, or Victorian tradition than with the Bible.
Humbug!
Oh, don't be cross, Uncle!
How can I help being cross, sir, when I live in such a world of fools as it is? A Merry Christmas! What's Christmas time to you, sir? The time for paying bills without money. Time for finding yourself a year older? Not a penny of it, sir. If I had my way, sir, every fool who goes about saying Merry Christmas should be boiled with his own pudding and buried with a stake of olive through his heart. He should.
Uncle!
Nephew, you keep Christmas your way. Let me keep it in mind.
Bah, humbug, as Scrooge would say. I thought what I'd do is have a look at one iconic item of the modern Christmas, the Christmas tree, and see what relationship at all it has with the biblical idea of what Christmas is all about. Right down the ages, people have worshipped tree or tree-based objects as part of pagan rituals. Gods on poles like Asherah or totem poles can be seen as examples of these. Whereas there are some legends of Christian saints, such as Saint Boniface, opposing tree-based rituals, there does not seem to have been any firm connection of the adoption of pagan worship of trees into Christian practice. The use of fir trees in Christmas celebrations can only be firmly traced back to Germany in the 16th century. It seems to have developed amongst followers of Martin Luther, known as Lutherans, who dressed fir trees with decorations and lights during the period Christians know as Advent, which is the preparation period just before Christmas, when they remember that God was bringing light into the world through the gift of his Son. The lights were lit on December nights to mark this. So how did Christmas trees get into the British Christmas? Well, they can be traced back to one man, and that's Prince Albert, the consort of Queen Victoria, who introduced them from his native Germany in the 19th century. And so to Felixstowe in 2012. The Christmas tree and the array of Christmas lights brighten up the dreary December nights. That was the whole idea of the Christmas tree, to emphasise that God's light was coming into the world. Here's what one of Jesus' disciples, called John, said about it. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Christmas isn't just about the birth of some famous guy, but the entry into the world of God as a human being. His purpose was simple: to bring us as people into a relationship with God. It's not a forced relationship, but a decision we need to consciously make. I just read how when he came, There were people that just wouldn't receive him. They just didn't want to know for whatever reason. It says this too. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave them the right to become children of God. So in the rush of a modern Christmas, don't let the sights and the sounds obscure Jesus, because in him are the answers to life and to eternity. Well, thanks for listening. May God bless you and have a really great Christmas.